In this video, I will share with you how you can place a trade on MetaTrader platform, what are the different options, and I have the MetaTrader platform open in front of me with an account from BlackBull Markets, so let's go for it. Welcome everyone to Trading Academy's channel. It's Petko Aleksandrov, and stay with me until the end of this video to see the different options of placing a trade on MetaTrader. For the purpose of this video, I have selected to use the BlackBull Markets that I have been using. And actually, if you have hard times finding a broker, you can check out our website at eatradingacademy.com. And we have the brokers page, which we have created to help our students and the beginner traders to choose their broker. I have written personally here a few tips and suggestions, and we have the recommended brokers tab. We have the cryptocurrency exchanges and wallets, and we have some more regulated brokers that we've been using. One more time, for the purpose of this video, I'll be using the BlackBull Markets, which is a regulated broker I've been using for quite a long time. Now, if you really don't know from where to start and how to install the MetaTrader, you're missing the first steps, I have already recorded a video about it, and you will see it right now in the right upper hand corner. And once you have the MetaTrader installed, you are ready for trading. Now, the easiest way to place a trade on MetaTrader is to use these one-click trading boxes. This is called one-click trading box because if I right-click over the chart, you see that I have the option to uncheck one-click trading, and this will make the box disappear. If I right-click again and I go to one-click trading, you will see that the box appears. So with this box, we see two things. We see the price at which we can sell and the price at which we can buy. And as you can notice, the prices are different. This is because we have a bid price and an ask price. The bid price is the cheaper one at which we are selling, and the ask price is the more expensive price at which we are buying. Okay, the difference between these two is called spread, and this is what the broker benefits from our trading, right? Just like the exchange bureaus or the banks, before you go to a vacation or to foreign country and you want to exchange one currency for another, you can buy it from the bank or the exchange bureau, and there is a difference between the bid and the ask price as well, right? This is how usually those brokers and exchanges make money. Now, in the middle, we have the lot. The lot is the quantity we want to be trading. So one lot in the Forex trading equals to 100,000 units. So if I want to buy one lot of euro dollar, I'll be actually purchasing 100,000 euro versus the American dollar. And of course, if you want to trade a smaller amount, you can decrease the lots to 0.05 or 0.01. You can choose 0.1, for example, which will equal to 10,000 euro versus the dollar. And let me demonstrate it to you. Let's say I'm following some strategy that shows me that currently the trend is going down, euro dollar is going down, so I decide to sell it. I will click on sell, and here is the warning with the disclaimer, which appears just one time right after you install the platform. If I click on I accept these terms and conditions and I click on OK, I won't see this disclaimer anymore. So now if I click on sell, the trade is executed immediately. I can see it below in the terminal. So you saw that I actually executed this trade, or I placed this trade with one click, and this is why it is called one click trading, this box, because we can sell or buy with a click of a mouse. All right, so what are the other options to open trade or to place a trade on MetaTrader? You can right click over the chart and you can go to trading, and here you have the option for a new order. Now, here comes a box with more details about what type of order you want to have. Is it market execution? So the one-click trading is a market execution because I click sell and the broker executes the trade at the market price, or this is the current price we have on the market. All right, so if I click on the order type, I have a second option which says pending order. If I select it, you will see that a new box opens below, and now I have four different types of pending orders. One is called buy limit, which means that I can set a price lower than the current one, and if the price reaches this level, a buy position will be executed. For example, currently we have the price at 117.66. So if I select 170.60, I will click on place, and you will see that this pending order is below at 117.60. Okay, and currently we have 117.66. So if the price drops, let me close this open position. I just wanted to demonstrate how this one-click trading works. It's on a loss, really doesn't matter because this is a virtual account that I have opened for the purpose of this video. So now I have left with the buy limit order, which one more time will execute a buy position if the price reaches the level at 117.60, which is just 6 pips lower, very possible for the price to reach the level while I'm recording this video. And let's see if this will happen or not. And during this time, I will explain the other types of pending orders. Okay, so buy limit, one more time, means that we set a level lower than the current price at which we want to buy. And as well, we have the option for expiry. So if you want this to happen by the end of the day, but you don't want to leave such an order for tomorrow, you can just set an expiry by the end of the trading day. Okay, the next option is sell limit, which obviously is the very opposite thing. We can set an order that will execute, for example, let's squeeze the price right here. I will put it at 117.70. Okay, I will click on place, and you will see that now I will switch to M15 so we can see better. We have a sell limit on the top, a higher level, which will execute a sell trade or a short position if the price reaches this level of 117.70. So guys, this is not a trading strategy that I'm showing at the current moment. I'm just explaining how to place a trade on MetaTrader and what are the different options you have. Okay, so let's see which one of the two the price will reach first. And again, I will go to trading new order, and the other two options are buy stop and sell stop. So the buy stop is the option to place a level on the market higher than the current price where we want to buy. For example, if I set it to 117.80 and I click on place, we will see the order here, but this is a buy stop, or if the price reaches this level, it will open a buy position. Okay, so it's kind of opposite to the buy limit, because with the buy limit, it will still open a buy position, but on a lower level than the current price. Okay, and the fourth option, as you may guess already, is the sell stop. Here it is. So that's a level we can place lower than the current price. So let me place it on 117.50. And we will see the order right here. And this means that we will sell euro dollar at this level, which is lower than the current price. And now the price is going very close. Yep, exactly. It executed this sell limit. And you see that once the price reached the level of 117.70, it opened the short trade automatically. So I didn't wait with my mouse on the sell button to wait for 117.70 to be reached and to sell it manually, but it happened automatically by using those pending orders. And why those are useful? First of all, I don't need to sit in front of the computer and to wait to tremble with my finger on the mouse to execute at the right price. You see that if you want a certain price, you can set it up with a pending order and it will execute at that price. And this is actually a good sign of a decent broker, that it executes the pending orders exactly on the price you want. Okay? If you notice that your broker doesn't execute pending orders on the prices you want to have, then there is something wrong with that broker and you better look for a new broker. All right, so these are the different options MetaTrader offers. Of course, you can use expert advisors or the so-called robots that we show in our courses and we use for our trading in Trading Academy, because they execute trades based on different strategies fully automatically. But this I'll be talking about in another video. For the current moment, I wanted to show you how you can use the one-click trading on MetaTrader, or how you can place pending orders one more time. Four different options for pending orders: the buy limit, sell limit, buy stop and sell stop, and pretty much discovers all possibilities of placing an order on MetaTrader. If you want to buy on a higher price, then you need to use the buy stop. If you want to sell on a lower price, you need to use the sell stop. If you want to sell on a higher price, you need to use the sell limit, which was demonstrated in this video. And if you want to buy on a cheaper price than the current level, you can use the buy limit. All right, so these are the different options on MetaTrader for placing a trade. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. I'll be super happy to answer you. And if you have found the video useful, thumbs up, enjoy trading, check out the links below in the description, and I will see you guys in another video. Take care and enjoy trading. Bye.